Cactus Jack.
We have seen Flying Brian in action so much and have been so impressed by this great young man. We have not seen Cactus Jack, but Terry, I know you have heard of him and you have heard of his reputation as a real demonic character.
Absolutely, from the land of enchantment, New Mexico. He's a very, very great competitor, and you're wrong about that, as I have watched him wrestle before and in Japan. Very aggressive, very good athlete.
His right hand taped there into a standing side headlock. Pillman pushes him to the ropes. Football tackle, Pillman right down. Cactus Jack jumps over him. Pillman with a high leapfrog and a hip toss. Pillman with a high dropkick.
Speaking of great athletes, do we have one there or not? But a smart move by Manson. Do you see how he grabbed him by the back? That ring, a very smart move. Now he has him on what he thinks is his ground, because Cactus Jack is a rough competitor.
Oh. Wow, Pillman just driven so hard into that safety barrier.
I hope that he's not hurt seriously from that one. I hope he can get back up and get back in the ring.
That's going to slow him down somewhat. Pillman waiting for Cactus Jack now, though, and he leaps over the ropes. Just a high cross body block. Goes for. That's two. That was close. Sets him up for a shot.
Gosh, these guys are getting tougher. That's why I got out of the wrestling profession, right there. Trading blows back and forth, and you can hear them throughout this entire arena.
Pillman is out in a hip toss. Cactus Jack is down. High knee, it looked like there. And an arm drag into an arm bar. Well, an impressive series of blows there. As tough as those chops were from Pillman, Manson was able to come right back.
That's a Japanese arm bar applied by Brian Pillman right there, and it's a very painful maneuver.
Where specifically is the pain centered on a move like this? On a hold like that, I should
say. In the elbow. It straightens the elbow out, takes it past as far as it can bend, and it has a tremendous amount of pain to it there.
Now a standing arm bar. How does that differ from what we just saw?
It doesn't put the same amount of pressure on the elbow. That's more of a wrist lock right there, which puts the pressure on the shoulder.
That's how Cactus Jack was able to pretty much back him back. Pillman into the turnbuckle. We didn't expect a clean break, and we got just what we didn't expect.
What a mean cookie this Cactus Jack is. Put him in a turnbuckle.
Oh! Almost nailed our cameraman as well. A shot!
Right to the throat that time. The referee should have watched that one. That was into the throat. A good kick by Cactus Jack. Here he comes with a clothesline right there.
Whoa, he just...
Holy mackerel.
Cactus Jack went over the top rope. You see him.
He hooked onto that. He hooked onto the head of Brian Pillman. He says, I'll tell you what, if Pillman gets up from this, you're talking about a tough kid right
he
there.
He just dragged him from the neck. Wow. As impressive as Brian Pillman is and has been, you've got to give a lot of credit to this newcomer. Wow.
That has to be the most vicious move. That has to be the move of the week as far as vicious is concerned. He goes right to work on that neck, too. Cactus Jack is a competitor, and he knows what he's doing. I told you I watched him in Japan before, Crispy.
Yes, you have. That's a, wow, about a 2.5. I have never seen a move like that. I thought Cactus Jack had missed that clothesline and was going to go over the top rope. This looks like a neck. He's got it on him. Instead, he grabbed him by the neck, the jaw, and just dragged him outside the ring.
This might be it. Two count.
How Pillman is able to count out of here, fans, is beyond me.
Just like Ole and Arn go for that arm, this man goes for the neck. He's continually back on the neck, which is very smart. Very smart wrestler. You hurt that neck, and I'll tell you what, it's a tremendously painful thing. Russian lunge.
Pillman is going to be one sore young man. In fact, for the next couple of days.
I can't believe it. Pillman came out of there again. Hey, isn't that great, Crispy? I'll tell you what, this
so many near fall situations here. Hard to believe that Pillman is going to come out of this on top. It's still possible, but gee.
I don't, from the looks of things right now, I don't think he will at all. He's going, will I sweep him here? No, it's a back. Back to belly suplex. Back to belly suplex on the floor.
That was just what Pillman needed. He may get some breathing time now, if he can possibly recuperate quickly.
Pillman's neck is hurting. Jack's pulling himself back up in the ring. The referee's on four. There's five. Here comes six. Both men are back in the ring.
But Pillman clearly the worst for
wear. Oh!
Somehow Pillman pulls it out, but it's reversed. Attempted a clothesline there by Manson. A flying elbow, and Manson is down, and Pillman is hot.
What a main event match today we have for you. What a great match.
High back body drop. Manson is getting a little bit back of what he dished out to Pillman. There's another chop. Another one. Wow. You can hear these throughout Dork Narita here in Raleigh.
Clothesline into that corner, and you have no place to go.
Where Manson is coming up with it after getting the best that Pillman can dish out again is beyond me.
The tide has turned on this match time after time. There goes a flying crucifix right there. There's a three count. What a beautiful move. What a great move by Brian Pillman. Flying crucifix.
Pillman pulled it out, but just barely with that flying crucifix. What a great move. Cactus Jack, he's just beside himself. He thought he had this match won.
That's no.